only 585 and 4.
We are building up the 585 by having constructive conversations about what's going on in and around the town. So without further wait,
let's get into it. Make sure y'all like and tune in on all social media platforms. Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at 585 and 4. If you are not on social media, link us on the TuneIn app on 100.9 WXIR Extreme Independent Radio. Lego!
Yes, yes, yes. I'm so excited about today's show. I know I say that all the time, but I'm really excited about today's show. First of all, we got guest host Chris Thomas in the building.
What's up, people?
And we got Miss Shannon Scott.
Shannon Scott looking like a snack, looking like a whole contract.
She does braids, crochet styles, and natural hairdos. And Misha, she's also a stylist. She does quick weaves, ponytails, and sew-ins, and so forth. So we're pretty much a full service salon. She also does nails too, but we just don't have the space for that yet. But soon come.
Y'all do dreads?
Yes, we just hired a new girl. We shout out Nick Style. She specializes in a lot of retwists. So yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I need one of those right now. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I know.
Different styles. You got leave out, you got frontals, you got closures, you got all pull up, you got there's so many different varieties of sewing. So frontal and closures, they fall into the sewing category. Okay. But you can also get them done as a quick weave too.
I had a closure before, but I never had a frontal.
Mm-hmm. Or a lot of people do them as wigs. So that way, to me, that's the best investment because you can take it off of them and it'll last longer.
School of us, and the frontals, the clothes, like all of that. I want my next hairstyle. I want what you want. What you got? That is beautiful. Okay.
Thank you. We shout out BSW. I got the Remy Velvet, the Burgundy. I typically do bundles, but with the color, for me being allergic to everything, okay. I got the pack hair this time.
Okay, and that's part of their services too. What products do you sell?
I sell hair bundles, frontals, closures. I also have a handmade crafted hair potion that I make myself that has been getting really great reviews. It's growing people's scalp, it's all natural, and it's full of essential oils and tea tree oil is the key one, and it stimulates the growth of the hair and it helps with the flakes. A lot of people have dry scalp when they leave their weaves in too long, so that's like the perfect product.
You guys need to come out.
So, like,
Soul
City is like the one stop shop, basically.
Pretty much. That's the goal.
Okay. So, Shannon, tell us a little bit about your dreams. Was there ever a time where you felt like your dreams were too big? And if so, how did you persevere through the challenges?
Yes. Sometimes my dreams still scare me to this day. But the more I educate myself, the more I learn that it's all part of the plan. And if your dreams don't scare you, then you're just too comfortable. So I did around my year, my second or third year, when I wasn't really used to the curve of the shop, the clientele, when it goes down and goes up a certain season, I wanted to give up. And I did. I closed my shop for like 6 months. I'm like, I just can't do this because I just went through a little rough swell, not knowing that this is just a curve that I needed to learn how to get used to. Mm-hmm. So over time, I persevered. And it's just not giving up. That's just the key thing. When you learn perseverance, and I'm only here because I didn't quit. I quit for a little bit, but I was more depressed quitting than I was a little bit tight for real.
Yeah, so I know having a conversation with you, like, she talked boss talk. Like, listen, when she's talking profit analysis, and I'm like, okay, this has to make me work. Depleting myself, I was missing family and events and things like that.
once you realize that you got to transition from booked and busy to being more productive,
yeah,
and that's what keeps you in business longer. And like right now, I'm like, listen, I've been an entrepreneur since I was 14. You know what I'm saying? So it's like now I'm trying to transition from entrepreneur to executive. You know what I'm saying?
And then passive income,
and also duplicating myself, giving everything I know, all my talents, all my gifts, my skills, I'm giving it away. If you want to work for me, I'm gonna give it to you, because eventually my clients are gonna want to see you. Somebody got, you know, keep towards going. And you know, we're trying to build generational wealth. We're a family-owned business, you know. We're trying to leave a mark, let people know the Scott girls, you know, not playing, you know, and set an example in our community, because we're all from the inner city.
That's one thing I love about you, though. You're all about, just like we all need. It's not no stepping on anybody's toes, but it's just like, okay, I have these jewels, I have these gems, I want to be able to give it to anybody who's willing to, you know,
you
receive
want
them. But I know that you strive on building up your community, and you have participated in, you know, many other events and engagements such as Friendsgiving. So tell us your philosophy on community engagement.
Your community is everything. Giving it to my community is what got me, awarded me the opportunity to even purchase that property. Because I purchased the property cash, and people, you know, wouldn't believe, like, the building cost probably as much as a pair of Chanel sneakers or maybe a bag. But, you know, me being in a situation in the community, I serve for my Portland Avenue Business Association. So we do give backs every year at our community festival. And when it came time, I just put it out there. Hey, I want to buy my building. That's why you can't always hold your dreams in. You got to let them out. Because people are like, oh, people are praying it down for you. You can't worry about that. As long as you pray to put your dreams out there, because it might be somebody listening like, you know what? Because when I was at one meeting, one of the big wigs at the city was at our meeting, and our street manager was just like, help her. Whatever she want to do, help her. Here I am, bad credit, have my own business for how long, but I was like, big on cash, because I'm like, I need cash, so I need credit, you know what I'm saying? So with my credit, I didn't realize how much I needed, but I was able to be in a situation that they gave me a property where most times when they do the type of sale I did, you have to have good credit, you have to have over tens of thousands of dollars in the bank. I ain't even had that. I was calling my friends, girl, let me borrow $500. Girl, let me borrow $300. You know what I'm saying? And scrape my savings out, bought that building, and just stepped out on faith. And it cost almost $150 to get $1,000 to get it done. But that's why you gotta be a visionary, because it's like, I don't have that money, but if they could tell this person to help me with this, somebody will help me with that.
That's so empowering. And I think, and I've heard that, and it can sound cliche, but I've heard so many people even write stats though, and I felt that way sometimes, where it's like, you know, I don't know if I want to tell this person, because you never know how they may perceive it, and people praying against it. And so to hear you say, you know, at the end of the day, what's for you is what's for you, basically. And I think that's inspiring, where it's like, and not trying to get too religious, but it's like, if it's yours, it's yours. It don't matter who you tell, it don't matter if you write a stat. If it's yours, it's yours.
Talk to us about the future of Sewing City. What is your ultimate goal?
The future of Sewing City, the ultimate goal is to, like I said, just be a wealth of knowledge and be kind of like a mentorship program to the youth, you know, kind of mold younger girls and at an early age to, you know, not only in hair, just finding their vision now and feeding it now. My goal was, when we were younger, I had big cousins, like my cousin Shanta. She was my god sister, and she's my older cousin, we call her the GOAT. But she always mentored me, and I think that's what we're lacking now. We need people who are gonna take that young person under their wing. And when you give back to the youth and the young, it just, bigger doors open for you, more resources come. So it's like, I'm just gonna give away all the knowledge that I got to my community and use my shop, my more bigger, modern shop, you know what I'm saying, to show as an example. Listen, you don't always gotta start big. Everybody wanna start up top tier, you know what I'm saying? And that's not the way. You gotta take the step. You cannot get in the elevator. You gotta put in the work, because that's what's gonna determine whether you stay in business. You might just start it off with a bang, but then you look up years later, people don't even know you have a business, or your business is no longer. So.
So what tips would you offer to young aspiring hairstylists or business owners? And are you looking to mentor young women?
Yes, I am. The tips that I would give people is study yourself. Figure out what it is you really love to do, because when you work, it shouldn't feel like work. You you should love what you're doing. And a lot of things that people don't do is they don't seek help. They don't or don't do enough research in the beginning. Like, it was a pleasure talking with you, Etienne, because I feel like most people going into business that are new, you should get a consultant, because it'll stop you from making a lot of financial mistakes that I made, you know, not knowing. But it was just like, good thing I didn't give up, because most people would have quit after they took as many losses as I did. But reach out, do your research, and get a clear plan before you even start, so you're not like aiming at empty targets.
Okay. So, where can people, well, first of all, are you taking new clients? I know it's COVID and business has been kind of crazy, but are you taking new clients still?
Yeah, I'm taking new clients. Anybody can book with me as long as you go on my booking site. You can get the link right off under my Instagram. And I do have like intake forms on my booking site that ask you all the COVID questions. And when you come in, we check temperatures. We all have our proper protective equipment on. We sanitize and we do another intake form when you come in. So yeah, we're always welcoming new people.
Okay, so what's your Instagram? Where can people find you on social media?
I'm at Sewing City on Instagram. That's SEW_N_City. And Sewing City on Facebook as well. And Sewing City Clubhouse.
Hey, Clubhouse. Like, you guys find me anywhere, basically.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. Thank you, Shannon, so much for that interview. You definitely dropped the jewels. We're going to come back with the college. You're listening to the 585 Report, 100.9 WXII. Rewind, go back to our pages and listen to All right, so we're gonna get into this couch. And I had like a whole long post, but we shortened it a little bit. And it's okay, because it's like, it's kind of like what the other guy was saying, but he had like so many thoughts. So we're gonna get into this couch.
And we got the perfect person for it.
Yes.
Because he ruffles feathers and he does not care, and he's all about men empowerment.
All right. So this was a social media post that I legit just saw. So women, I want a man who, Kevin R. Samuels. Keep in mind that you have two children, you're 39, now finished. What were you saying? So.
This is so perfect for a pod that me and you are gonna drop pretty soon. I'm sure you forgot about
this. I know, because we recorded in August.
Yeah. I think this is like a case of like knowing your standards, having like correct standards. Shout out to Kevin Samuels. I don't agree with him with all stuff and the way he delivered this is harsh, but long story short, like if a man gets at a woman and women always say men need to be ready, men need to be prepared, you need to have your stuff together. Don't come at me if you broke, don't come at me if you got kids all over the city. Don't come at me if you don't got a 1 year, a 6 month, a 5 year plan, all that good stuff. So don't be upset when men got the same energy. Like if you're a man of high value, then you're gonna be able to choose what you want. Now, basically that's the way it's saying it. I don't think it's proper etiquette to, you know, you meet a woman and she tells you her age and then and you just cut her off. I wouldn't do that. But long story short, that's what he's doing. Just making sure everybody's standards are correct and not saying she should lower her standards. I'm just saying that people have standards, and that was that particular guy's standards. And maybe that maybe she should understand or know when she's going in the dating realm that it's competition. Like some men, the man that she wants may be more attracted to a woman that may not have kids yet, if he doesn't have kids and stuff like that. So,
I think when people start talking about because you have this certain amount of kids that you aren't or you shouldn't have your standards high, I don't necessarily agree with that. I mean, I feel like if I want a person, I have two kids. My kids are 19 and 14. And then I want a person, I'm going to go after them. Like, I'm not going to care what, oh, you have two kids. Keep in mind that you have two kids. What?
And you're 39. And you're 39.
Because I bring a lot to the table. Not only do I have two kids, I'm a business owner. I'm a director of a homeless shelter. I'm working on my second master's degree. I'm not the best cook, though. So that might, put me down in a little bit. But, I mean, I bring a lot to the table. So nobody's going to tell me, oh, you have two kids. Think about what you're going to say before you say it. No. Like, because I know and I have an idea of the man that I want in my mind. And I'm going to go after.
I completely agree with that. I think it's just more important to know that people know that it's an opportunity that may present itself that somebody may not rock with you just because of that. And I'm sure anybody knows that. Like, everybody got their preference. So, like I said, I don't think, just like for men, I tell men, like, yo, don't let being broke stop you as long as you know inside your heart that you're really trying to turn a new leaf over. Don't let being broke stop you. So she might see what you got going and might ride with you until you get better. But understand that she might also be like, bro, you don't even got, I can't, no. So it's the same with the 39 with two kids. Like, not saying that you don't bring up much to the table. You can't get any man you want, but some men just might be like, that's not for me, so.
Right. I've heard men say I prefer, women without children.
It's not even that, because I don't have kids yet. I just think that this is more of women have unrealistic standards. That's why I said, me and you going to drop this pod. It's called Spoiled versus High Standards.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, you can't be, like, you can be whatever you want, but just be realistic. Like, have some common sense. Like I said, if you're looking at a man that has no job, he got kids all over the city out of wedlock, he got felonies, he in and out of jail, he's, like, not doing well. That man can't realistically expect or get upset. He can expect whatever, but he can't be upset when the woman of his dreams that may be making six figures and own a business and da 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 look at him like he's No, because it's that's all that is. You know what I'm saying? A lot of women struggle with that. I feel like women struggle with that. They're like, if you can't accept me flaws and all this, it's dumb.
What are your thoughts?
Right, I get that. I feel like in this situation, though, I feel like how he brought it up was like, hold on, since you're limited because you got two kids and you got four. So I get what you're saying, Chris. I definitely hear you speak too. So it's like, yeah, again, I may be 39, I may have two children, but I bring a lot more to the table. Just because I'm 39 with two children doesn't mean that I should lower my expectations or my standard of a man. Now, contrary, there may be some men who are interested in a 39-year-old woman with two children that has X amount of degrees in business, whatever, whatever. So I'm going to keep my standards up here. So Kevin, I don't care what you're saying. That man may not be for me, but it may be another one who's for me.
That's a fact. That's a fact. One last thing I want to say real quick is, as I read this, you got to, like, really read it. I want a man who. That's why he said stop, because, like I said, if a dude was in the low tier and was like, yo, I want a woman who do this, like, bro, you don't even have a job. And a lot of women be like, well, if she got four kids, and she might say, I want a man with no kids. And if she got no job, I want a man that's a millionaire. He going to take care of me. That's where I think that's coming from. Just unrealistic expectations. On the surface, I'm not saying you can't go get your millionaire, baby, if you ain't got no job and you got 100 kids. Go get your millionaire, baby. Do your thing.
No, seriously, because I think about, like, the Instagram models who get their bodies done, and that's what they do. Like, they are for the gram, and they have, like, big paid promotions, and they have the shakes, and they have the waist trainers, and that's how they get their money. But they ain't looking for no, you know, down here kind of guy. They looking for a top tier, maybe like a retired basketball player. Not the A-listers, but maybe a B-lister who still got some money.
Women are trained to date up. That's just how y'all train from birth. Y'all train to find a man. It's the whole security versus physical.
Shannon, you got some thoughts?
Yeah, I just feel like you attract what you are, no matter how many kids you are. If you got your standards up here, you're going to attract them. So that's where the unrealistic expectation piece that I agree with that, because you can't be unemployed seeking somebody who's an entrepreneur, because they're not going to be attracted to laziness. So just work on yourself.
Alright, so that was the couch. We're going to get into some news, some current events. I think my battery's dying on my mouse, so that's okay. So this was exciting that New York has been lifted COVID restrictions in all orange zones and most yellow zones. So I was excited about that, because now you can have more people here. What's the occupancy now, you know?
I don't think we have more than 8 to 10 people inside our salon, but at least we get to reopen, because the first 10 that we got in the orange, we had to close down.
Oh, okay.
So now we can reopen.
I think this is like the best COVID news we've had since we've been talking about COVID.
Well, I mean, for those who are going to get the vaccine, that was also, you know, pretty great, because, you know, I'm not for it, but I got people who I really want to get it, because I don't want them to catch COVID. I don't want them to die from COVID. So, yeah. I mean, they're a vulnerable population, so there's people in my life that I really want to get vaccinated. But back to the COVID restrictions, they have been lifted. The 10 p.m. curfew for bars and restaurants are still in effect, and it's the 33% capacity for gyms and fitness centers. So that's still the same. They've also changed the amount of people that can sit at tables, which to me, that was really dumb anyways. So I believe it's 10 people, no more than 10 people can sit at a table now. So I'm happy about, because it looks like the light is at the end of the tunnel. Like, we're
almost there. We're going to talk to
this is sad. Like, I don't keep up with none of this stuff. I'm a whole nurse and I don't keep up with it. Like,
oh, wow.
I think it's just that my routine is so in itself that I don't really care what's open or what's not. Like, if I'm a only thing that it affects is like going out to eat, like maybe going out on a date. But other than that, I don't remember none of the places closing for the last 6 months. I've been going out places, so this is good news.
Places have been closing because Monday night is my date night. So that's how I know. We were very limited in places we could go. Okay. So that's how I know. And
like, it's me.
take care of a little boy on one of my cases, and we can't play. I can't play. We get tested weekly, and like he's real immunocompromised. So like I ain't been to a club since all year. Maybe I might have went in January, but as soon as it started, you know, I'm like, yo, wake me up when we can travel again. Right. We can travel, right. Travel, like, yeah.
Like,
you know,
my passport. Yeah. Like, yeah, that's me.
Right.
And they supposedly spread out, like 3,000.
And they had to produce a negative.
3,000. But no, we saw on TV, like, it wasn't spread out. We saw it on TV, like, it was really, like, shout out to Bill's mom.
Yeah, they were going to see their
teammates
get vaccinated, but that's exciting news. However, talking about the vaccine, a lot of people have been having side effects from the vaccine. Yeah, so a lady that's one of my volunteers, her arm swelled up so huge, and it was like really red and hot to the touch. Damn. And a week later, it was like a bruise. It looks like a bruise.
Oh, wow.
And she was sick. She couldn't even come in for a few shifts. Mm-hmm. So the side effects are fever, chills, being tired, having a headache. And if you are experiencing some of these, make sure you talk to your doctor about it. They say the redness and tenderness where you got the shot increases after 24 hours, or if the side effects don't go away after a few days, make sure you are reaching out to your doctor. So I'm still happy that we were able to get vaccinated, though. Some people are coming up on their second shot. Mm-hmm. And then did you hear that Johnson & Johnson, they developed the shot, even though the efficacy, is that the word, efficacy, is only 66%. Mm-hmm. It's only supposed to be a one shot. Like, you know, the other ones are two doses, but this one is only one shot, but it's only 66% effective. So, I mean, take how you want it.
Yeah, who knows if you want this. Shameless promotion, rape and consent, toxic masculinity podcast. Check that out. Available on all platforms. But yeah, I just think that I seriously doubt that. Like, you shouldn't take advantage of nobody. That's not with it. But I seriously doubt that they drugged anybody. I doubt that. Like, the way it seems like they get down is they're swingers. They do what they do. They go out to the club. They get strippers. They're sure going to come back to the house. Oh, it's Tiny and T.I. Yes. Okay. T.I. might tell them off top. You're not coming in here unless you take this, this, and this. Mm-hmm. If not, you
or
can
we
go.
Got this, this, and this right here.
Yeah. Like, you have to take this or you can go. Mm-hmm. They then have that decision. Like, to me, that's not when it's written. Now, after they take it and they doze off and they sleep, then if you do something to like a cadaver at that point, then yeah, that's written. But like, you can't just be like, oh, I went there and I took the drug and then we had sex and it's not ready to take advantage of me. Like, yo, you knew what it was. Like, you know what they do.
Yeah.
If this is true.
I feel like I'm on the same wave. And I know people are like, well, black women are protected, da 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 da.
They can't put them.
Ain't Tiny a black
woman? Exactly.
But Tiny black too, ain't she?
Is she racist?
Yeah, she's white.
She ain't getting protected.
She considers herself black.
No, but I feel the same way. I just feel like when you become like a certain image or when you're influential or just a celebrity, like there's certain things that you just can't partake in despite what you want to do behind closed doors with your significant other. Like there's just some things that you just gotta say, because it's like we chose.
Right. Right. So I guess this woman, they've been having like issues with her for like over a decade, and they're ready to sue her because of all these allegations, taking legal matters. They were going back and forth on Instagram, and Tiny, she said he was just uncle 2 years ago. Now, when did you say my husband assaulted you? Did you change your mind or change it back? What is up with you today, Pooh? I'm confused. Stop harassing my family. So then the other lady clapped back and said, we can take a lie detector test.
Oh, no,
a
lie detector?
Right. Lie detector. That T.I. Oh, the gun to her head.
And T.I., he went on Instagram and went live and basically said he didn't do it. Basically.
And it's T.I. talk.
It is T.I. talk. You know, all the.
But it's plenty of women, not to interrupt, that will willingly go with T.I.
Exactly.
With a wife and all. So I don't believe it. People put themselves in situations like that.
And if you read the tweets, all of them have the same similar story. Oh, Tip and Tiny asked us to come. And like one girl was like, they told us we had to take ecstasy and we took it and we spit it in the drink. Like, why are you that thirsty? Like, if you doing all that, leave the situation. Like, you either with the S word or you not with it. Like, if you with it and you on that type of time and you taking drugs and you like having sex like that, well, then do that. But if you're not on that type of time, don't risk your livelihood for that bad.
I was gonna say, but I don't know, sometimes when you talk money though, like, for real, people...
Oh, yeah, like, she said, like, we got $3,000 or something for that night. Yeah.
I'm sure.
I'm sure.
All right, last bit of news, which is very sad. Cisely Tyson passed away at 96.
Wow.
Purposeful and pioneer actress.
I was so sad. I was like, oh, my God.
It's like certain people, like, you know we're all going to die. Certain people that she just like don't expect it from. So her family announced that she had passed away and didn't provide immediate details. We send our condolences to her family. I know she was known for not taking parts where that demeans women. She was not taking like any
welfare
bomb or ghetto prostitute.
Right.
All of that, she would only take, like, sort of like Giselle, he would only take roles that, you know, were great roles for black people, for the black image, not roles that demeaned us and made us look crazy. So, our condolences. We are going to take a quick break, and we are going to come back with Shameless Shawny.
I feel like some actual actors, when they become more delivered, like, you don't have to be a dumbass at all.
not going to answer unless, you know, somebody else, I have a feeling somebody going to ask me and want me to answer it. But, ladies, your men want you to stop hanging around your friends or do something you enjoy. What do you do? Why is it that so much of our self-identity is determined by the perception of others? Others, our significant others, our partners, whoever. How do we maintain our self-identity in a relationship? How do we create balance between ourselves and our significant other? You want me to stop or make you
go ahead?
Go ahead. Okay. Communicate. Do not lose your voice. I have been married for 11 years now. We have been together for 17 years. And I will say, at the beginning of our relationship, this was something that I struggled with, because I feel like as women, like, we, some may struggle with being submissive, but we want, like, our man to be happy, we want this, we want that, we have kids, and, like, we kind of, like, lose ourselves, our own identity. And that was love for me. That was me at one point in time. And so now, I'm just, like, on a self-love journey and just really, like, reinventing and recreating who Shane and Shawny is, who Shawny is. But I would say, so to maintain your self-identity in a relationship or just in general, continue to communicate. Do not lose your voice. And it might start a disagreement, an argument, whatever it is, but continue to communicate. Because the more you begin to just say, okay, you know what, I don't want to say this for the sake of an argument, or I want peace, or maybe he, she, whoever is right, you start to lose your voice. So continue to communicate. Do not lose your voice in your relationship. The moment you begin to lose your voice is the moment you begin to lose your identity. Keep an open mind. Even if you have something other, and for me, little baby, I don't like to listen. I don't. Despite how long we've been together, I don't like to listen. But I have to keep an open mind. So I may not like it, or I may hear what he's saying, but I'm not really receiving it. But I have to keep an open mind. So give, but don't allow yourself to be used. Love, but don't allow your heart to be abused. Trust, but don't be naive. Listen, but do not lose your voice. I'm gonna repeat that.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna go back up to the trust part, and I'm gonna go back up to the love part.
The toxic Love,
but don't allow your heart to be abused. And this right here, I feel like it's so significant, because we can love, 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 we can give our all. And it's like sometimes we may need to walk away, we may need to use our voice, whatever it is, and that's when we become, or we get abused, because we're like, oh, this is love, and it feels so good, and that, but what is your definition of love?
Right.
Trust, but don't be naive. I'm just going to repeat that one more time. Trust, but don't be naive, all right? Listen, but don't lose your own voice. Shane and Shawny.
All right. I mean, you said it all.
Shannon, the questions.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
And y'all, you get 5 seconds, 3 seconds for the
second
time.
So you say it first. We write it down, and then she says it. Okay.
I can ask these already. iOS or Android?
Mine's small. I mean,
small.
Okay. iOS.
105.
She said iOS.
Yeah.
Okay.
Definitely iOS.
Instagram followers or $100,000?
What's worse?
Laundry.
dishes. Ooh. I love laundry. Oh my God, I love laundry. I love laundry.
Chicken or beef?
Chicken.
Y'all both wrong. Shawny, you know
what?
I'm allergic to chicken.
Ooh!
You know I know chicken.
I'm
only seafood, but you know,
occasionally
I'll have beef, but no chicken.
Okay.
Well,
this
one.
No, we didn't.
Okay. A month without your car or a month without the internet?
That's hard.
That's easy. What's going on?
No, okay.
Without my car or without the internet?
Okay.
Internet.
So true. I can do without that internet. But my car, my baggie, no, I got to get
it. You got to get to the bag.
I got to get to the bag. I got to get to go.
Perfect teeth or perfect hair?
That one higher, but I'm going to guess on
the
next one.
Yeah, I should have played this game too. I'm
going to do it over.
Yeah, you
hair.
Got that one right, hair
all day. I would have got that one wrong. Cause I figured like hair.
Cause
is
I'm
so
just not working these
teeth,
these braces.
I just thought like since you do hair, like, you can get the perfect hair like that.
Well,
you know
that
she
has braces.
All right. Yeah, a pregnant teenage daughter or a junkie teenage daughter? What?
I thought this was funny.
Ooh, you know.
Cheat or being cheated on?
That last set it off.
Who is ever going to choose? I want to get cheated on. I don't want to cheat. If I had to choose, I would rather get cheated on.
No, I used to be a cheater.
What?
I'm
going
to incriminate myself on this good show.
I'm going to cheat first.
Fellas, y'all hear this? TMP, y'all hear this?
Not anymore.
Chocolate or vanilla? Successful career or a happy family life?
That's a
bad one. Y'all gotta ask me these questions. That's how my career.
Career. Trying to make it up now.
No, I'm gonna give that to y'all because it has been that. But I'm changing my life.
Isn't it easier to have a happy life or have a successful career?
Yes.
Oh, I thought that was
good. Not all, but sometimes.
Oh, okay. A live-in massage therapist or a live-in chef?
Ooh.
Wow, that's
you know me originally.
That
would
go
really
fast.
I don't even
like
the
queen.
Chef.
Ooh!
Excuse me, one second, I'm sorry. Oh, no, keep it going, Number one gotta be my thing. Come on. I'm mad y'all didn't put my business as number one.
Oh,
Shawny
did this.
Shawny?
I threw you under the bus.
Yeah. Oh, and that's bad. But look, the number one reason Shawny meant to put is a package from Love Nest LLC.
Oh, yes.
Interior romantic decorated. We've been around since 2015. Offer imitated, never duplicated. Over 400 jobs done. And if we can't come, we'll deliver a box with rose petals, candles, teddy bears, chocolates, all that, so you can do delivery yourself. Don't settle for nothing.
Wait, what's your Instagram?
At LoveNests. Facebook, LoveNests. www.lovenest.com.
Yes, I'm so sorry for that.
Right. But the rest of these, you know, yeah.
But number one, love it. All right. All right. So, either get it out of here or have it. hell yeah. All right. Number one, a reversible purse or a pair of sneakers?
I'm going to say sneakers.
Sneakers.
I ain't never
going to say sneaker me.
Yeah.
I thought y'all was going to say get them both on.
Yeah. Makeup brush set or stud earrings?
Stud earrings.
Get that makeup brush out of here.
Custom love journal or his and her sweatshirts?
Custom love journal.
Really?
Why?
Yeah. I'm not even sure. I'm not even like that.
What's okay, the custom love journal?
It's annoying
for
the sweatshirt.
You know, it's a journal.
I don't know how you feel.
What's a custom love journal?
So I'm thinking it's like a couple thing, right? Or yeah. Yeah. Custom love journal?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's
a couple
because
you got the his and her sweatshirts.
It has
to be.
T.I. and
Tiny. All right, bracelet watch or ceramic
cutouts? Okay. Bracelet. Bracelet watch.
Board game or diffuser set?
Diffuser.
Get them both on here.
I'm a sucker for board games. I'm an 80s kid. I love board games. All right. Toiletry bag or cosmetic organizer?
Get them both out of here.
All right. Let me just get this. Business card holder or workout bag?
Workout bag.
Satin roll or match your DJs?
Satin roll me.
Satin roll.
Flowers or fruit bouquet?
Flowers.
Panties or bras? Wait, what's that going with? Bro.
Not a game is so good here, fellas. Not a game is so
good. All right, we're going to have to finish this next week because we got to get into CCC Fizz. All right, so I'll finish up with this or that or hell yeah or whatever out next week. CCC
work with yes men. Hire people who have the confidence to speak up. Humility and gratitude are the cornerstones of selflessness. Make a habit, taking a moment, reflect on all the people who were a part of making you successful that day, and that helps you to develop a natural sense of humility. Leadership is all about change and people, and people change every day. If we believe we found the universal key to leading people, then we've lost. We let our ego determine what we see, what we hear, and what we believe. We've let our past success damage our future success. So get that ego out of here. It doesn't belong in leadership and business. And do right by your customers. And that is CCC's business with ease.
Spit.
Hey,
a little bit of ego in there. Just a little bit.
No, most leaders don't even know that they're leaders. They don't set out to be leaders. If you set out to be a leader, with too much ego.
No, seriously, because when people ask me what I do, like, I never say I'm the director. I just say I work for Bethany House. I don't want people to treat me differently because of my title. I remember I went to the bank one day to deposit some checks, and I'm not the person who deposited, usually does it. And the person was like, oh, are you just one of the volunteers? And I was like, no, I'm the director. And then he just tried to treat me very different. He's like, oh, you're important. I'm like, well, everybody who works here is important, right? Not more important than another person. Mm-hmm. However, when we get titles sometimes, it leads to people having those egos. And then, you know, they get way up here when you have to bring them back down.
Mm-hmm. So, I think it's the reason why you and your men disagree with that, each other.
Because he's a man?
Yeah, because men... It's not even that, but you gotta have some sort of ego, especially if you're looked upon as a leader of men or other people, because you have to have that certain thing that sets you apart. Not saying it has to overpower you, but at the end of the day, you gotta be like, yeah, I'll stand on what I say, and that's why I say it.
Yes, exactly. When it's me, like the customer, I don't care about them. I don't go home to them, so right. I don't care nothing about them. Exactly. So, like, that's why I don't allow them to get to me. But we are at the end of our show. Such a good show! Such a good show.
We're through everything. We bringing that, get it out of here, or hell yeah, that.
Okay, we bringing it back.
Yeah, I got some
new
segments.
Yes. And we got gifts. All right, Shannon, thank you for coming on. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.